grateful and to express it. To be able to say, thank you, Lord, for everything that you have done, even for the things that you are yet to do. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that, is there a gentleman here?
No.
Ladies, I believe that God has done something for all of us. Even if it's just to say, thank you, Lord, I'm alive. There are some people that have not been able to get out of bed today, but me, I'm alive. Me, I am adventurous. I never thought that I would be here, but here I am. Amen? Well, you say, Pastor Mary, it is easy for you to say that. You have got no idea what I have gone through, somebody is saying. But you know what? I may not have an idea of what you have been through, but the God that created you, the one that knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb, knows exactly what you have been through. In fact, he saw the storm as it was headed your way. He saw the challenge as it was headed your way. He looked at it and then he turned around and he looked at you. And he saw your inner being. He saw that he has put something inside of you that can be able to stand that storm that is coming your way. The challenge that is coming your way. Because he measured it. He measured it. Oh, my shame. He measured it. And he decided that this storm shall last in your life 5 years. He knew that you would live for 5 years and that it would come to an end. Believe me, children of God, there is an expiry date as far as storms are concerned. There is an end date. No storm was meant to come and enter the domain of your life to remain there. It is just passing. In fact, you are on your journey to your destiny. And therefore, every challenge that you have gone through, every pain that you have gone through, God allowed it for a reason. He measured it and he said, this one shall be for 5 minutes. This one shall be for 5 hours. This one shall be for 12 months. He is a God who knows nothing that you and I have gone through has surprised him. Nothing. When the enemy thought he had you, that you were now done. Oh, now I have you. Now you are now completely done. You were having this pity party. Well, we have been standing in the gap and praying for you, waiting for you to get up and praise God. Because God is looking for that person that is going to raise up their hands and say, Father, it is so painful, but I thank you that you are still my God. Amen? Because the moments that we stand up and we praise him, believe me, miracle begin to happen. It was in the midst of the prison cells where Paul and them were praising God at midnight, meaning when it is most painful for you, not at midnight, 24 hours. No. When it is so painful, when you cannot even get up, that is when you say, Father, it is so painful, but I thank you because you are here. You have been the fourth man in the burning furnace. You have never left me. Are you going to be that generation that is going to praise God even when you are faced with death? Even when you are faced with the biggest storm that the enemy thinks he has ever brought? Because the Bible says in Psalms 100 verse 4, it says, enter